This amazing city-state has many high-profile attractions, but it has even more treasures to offer those willing to do a little extra research. Welcome to Mojo Travels, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 hidden gems in Singapore. Are you a fan of our videos? Be sure to subscribe to Mojo Travels and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos. For this list, we're looking at the spots that savvy travelers and locals love in this bustling city, but that you might not have previously heard of. Number 10, Kebun Baru Birdsinging Club. Unless you're big into birds, we think this particular attraction will be unlike anything you've ever seen or heard before. People of Singapore seem to have a deep love for songbirds. And so, every morning, bird owners and bird enthusiasts gather in this dedicated green space where songbirds are hoisted onto poles 20 feet in the air in their ornate cages. It's an opportunity for these highly coveted and beloved pets to get the fresh air they crave, relax at the heights their species are used to, and share their songs, both with each other and the people who come to listen. It makes for quite the sight and an unforgettable photo op. Number 9, Kranji Marshes. Indeed, Singapore is a city that prides itself on its green spaces, which, considering the limited area it has to work with and its cutting-edge architecture, is really saying a lot. While the gardens by the bay and the botanic gardens are world-renowned, appearing on most trip itineraries, those looking for a more peaceful natural space, with even more avian excitement, may be more at home in the Kranji Marshes. Located in the northwestern part of Singapore and covering roughly 140 acres of land, these freshwater marshlands are home to over 170 species of birds, as well as numerous types of butterflies. Though the land is dedicated to biodiversity and conservation, humans are welcome to visit and are sure to appreciate the walking paths, the floating boardwalk, and the beautiful view from the top of the architecturally unique Raptor Tower. Number 8, Smoke and Mirrors. Museums and booze go together like, well, they actually don't usually go together at all. Conventions be damned, however. This destination rooftop bar makes a strong case that more museums should consider getting a watering hole of their very own. Perched atop the National Gallery Singapore, Smoke and Mirrors reminds us that a good cocktail is a work of art in its own right. These drinks are more than well-balanced. Their flavors and presentation are thematic, imbuing every cocktail with meaning. As Vanessa Teo of Hedonist Magazine wrote in 2018, quote, Smoke and Mirrors serves up a multi-sensory experience based on complex flavors, artful presentations, and optical illusions. And, with its sculpted bar, breathtaking view, and stylish decor, the space is remarkable in its own right. Number 7, the German Girl Shrine. Pulau Ubin is a small island to the northeast of mainland Singapore. It's a popular day trip for both locals and visitors alike, as the largely undeveloped land offers a much-needed break from the hustle and bustle of the city. While most people visit to go biking or appreciate the flora and fauna, those with an interest in the supernatural or spiritual will find another reason to make the trip. Located near the Kuttam Quarry on the western part of the island is a shrine to an unnamed German girl. The daughter of a plantation owner, she fell to her death in the neighboring quarry when pursued by British soldiers in the lead-up to World War I. Over the years, she's become a local deity of sorts, and her shrine, a destination for curious travelers. Number 6, Aliwal Art Center. One of the things that Singapore is perhaps best known for is its many hyper-strict laws pertaining to public order and tidiness. Chewing gum is generally forbidden, as is spitting. Littering comes with a noticeably heftier fine than elsewhere, and graffiti can get you jail time, or even a caning. And yet, despite the harsh punishments people can face for the latter, Singapore has a surprisingly awesome street art scene. You can thank the numerous shop owners who have embraced the art form, offering up their walls to street artists. Though street art can be spotted all throughout the city, Aliwal Art Center usually boasts some of the city's most impressive and unique murals, usually painted during their yearly urban arts festival. Number 5, Thow Kwang Pottery Jungle. In western Singapore, something wild slumbers. A holdover from a bygone era, it's the Thow Kwang Dragon Kiln. And when it comes to life, it is something to behold. Okay, we're being a bit dramatic, but compared to downtown Singapore's modern skyline, the setting of Thow Kwang Pottery does indeed feel wild. And the 70-year-old Dragon Kiln, the last operational one of its kind in Singapore, is freaking cool. Though the demand for pottery has largely, ironically, dried up, this business and its labyrinth of wares survives as a piece of history and a place to learn. Over 88 feet long, the Dragon Kiln can simultaneously fire thousands of pieces. But now that it's used only a few times per year, people are actually sometimes allowed to enter the kiln. Do you dare enter the belly of the beast? Number 4, the Mint Museum of Toys. You might grow out of playing with them, but toys maintain an undeniable appeal even for adults. There's just some inherent magic to these plastic and metal playthings that sparks the imagination. Whether you're a collector, a fan of museums in general, or just a curious mind, the Mint Museum of Toys is well worth a visit. It's a private collection of some 50,000 vintage toys dating back from the 19th to mid-20th century. Some toys are nostalgic, while others are downright creepy. But considering the wide range of pop culture it covers, every visitor is sure to encounter at least one toy that takes them back to their own childhood. MINT stands for Moment of Imagination and Nostalgia with Toys. And indeed, a visit is likely just what you need to reconnect with your inner child. Number 3. Katong Antique House. While we're on the subject of eclectic collections, let's talk about this delightful house full of history and oddities. Katong is a beautiful neighborhood located in the eastern portion of central Singapore. Its history is deeply intertwined with the Peranakan culture. Peranakans are a people of Chinese descent whose ancestors settled in Malaysia centuries ago, developing a distinct, hybridized cultural identity along the way. Today, Peranakan culture is slowly fading, but along with some key restaurants, Katong Antique House helps to keep the history of its people alive. Yes, there are many beautiful goods to marvel at, but more importantly, Katong Antique House is a crash course in an utterly unique culture that few know about. Number 2. Timber Plus. Singapore is famous for those numerous hawker markets, massive food courts where dozens to hundreds of food stalls serve up authentic street food from a variety of Asian cultures. For the record, you should visit as many of these food centers as you can. You may very well have some of the best bites of your life, and often for very cheap. For the serious foodies out there, however, we wanted to draw your attention to Timber Plus, which, although similar, is a bit more modern, diverse, and experimental. Billed as an upgraded urban food park, Timber Plus is made up of repurposed shipping containers, occupied by a mix of traditional food hawkers and the new generation of culinary rebels. The cuisines on offer are diverse, and between the live music, community events, and refreshing design, the atmosphere is simply awesome. Number 1. Kampong Lorong Buangkok. When people think of Singapore, a modern, luxurious, entrepreneurial city characterized by cutting-edge architecture is what springs to mind. The thing is, Singapore was a very different place as recently as the mid-20th century. Singapore used to be thick with kampongs, modest traditional villages that were inhabited by the native Malay people. Sadly, this way of life has all but disappeared. For those interested in not only Singapore's future, but its history as well, we'd highly recommend visiting Kampong Lorong Buangkok before it too disappears. Here at the last remaining kampong in mainland Singapore, and its remaining residents wouldn't have it any other way. They generally welcome visitors, but please, while you appreciate its charms, be respectful. Do you agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from Mojo Travels, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.